Now, how does a delicious dinner with just 6 ingredients sound? That sounds pretty good to me, let me tell you. Well, here to tell us more and cook some delicious pork chops with apples is best-selling author and founder of the hugely successful Hungry Girl franchise, Lisa Lillian. Welcome, Lisa. Give me a hug. 6 ingredients. I can handle this, everybody. Join a dip at the counter, Ken and Pagey. I mean, this is pretty amazing. So, Hungry Girl franchise, your series of books reached lucky number 13. Congratulations on that.
Thank you. That's a lot of books.
And now Hungry Girl is making Simply 6, which means just 6 ingredients in all these recipes.
Yes, 6 ingredients. That's what people want. I mean, after 13 books, I think I communicate with the audience and they're like, easier, please, fewer ingredients, less. So this entire book, 6 main ingredients or fewer.
But I mean, I think A, it's the simplicity of it, but B, also just keeping things natural, just real ingredients, like the, I mean, in some ways, the less the merrier. Does
that's
that make
right.
sense?
Absolutely. Right.
Okay. Back to basics.
Back to
how
basics.
Our ancestors basics. Ate. Mm-hmm.
And
that's
everything
exactly
in this book, every ingredient is all natural. So that's
here we go.
Awesome.
Pork chops. Okay, so we started with those. You sauteed those on the pan, right?
Yes, these have been cooked. Now, this is super easy. You just throw these in with a little Pam. No oil needed.
Huh.
A little salt and pepper. Cook them for about 3 minutes per side. Then you just put those aside and let them sit.
Okay, 3 minutes aside?
About 3 minutes
aside.
That's
it, really?
It's okay if they're a little pink in the center?
Depending on how thick they are. It's okay. I like to cook them through so you can, you know, cut and test and see
okay
when they cook to your liking.
Mm-hmm. But I know there's different philosophies on whether we should get a little pink in that pork or whether we kind of make it all white. So
I like them cooked through.
Okay.
Personally. But these, by the way, pork is so lean now, and these, yep, I've trimmed the fat off of them also. So it's like comparable to chicken as far as, right, you know,
you
calories
what you're,
and fat.
What you're cutting in ingredients, you're definitely not losing in flavor because all of your recipes in the book are so full of flavor.
Well, thank you.
They are, they really are.
Yeah, that's a good point, Deb, for sure. Okay, so all now right in the same pan.
Now in the same pan, you can clean it out or not, just be dirty.
Let's choose
okay
not.
Yeah, no, you want yes all that font.
Yes, I like it. Yes. So we're going to move that over. We have a cup of sliced onions and a cup
very
of
good
sliced apples.
I love
gonna
it.
Season those a little with a little salt and pepper.
Now, any choice of apples? Is it like sweet versus sour or whatever?
You know,
you, got
you can use the apple. I love Fuji apples. I use okay them for everything, so I like those. But you can use the whatever apple you like.
And just in case everybody's counting at home, the salt and pepper don't count in the 6.
No. That's right.
I'm just saying.
That's not a trick.
Just
it just
saying
doesn't count.
No, I just want to make
you guys seem disappointed.
So, this, so we've got the onions, we've got the apples.
It smells so good, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yes.
So like, yeah, cook these for about 10 to 12 minutes.
Very good, okay.
Until they're cooked down.
All right.
I
so
love
we'll,
it. You hear the sizzle?
Yes.
For the purpose
beautiful
of television, we'll cheat a little bit, though.
Okay.
We'll jump ahead. And once it's cooked 10 to 12 minutes,
yes,
like you say, once we've cooked it down a little bit, we've added the salt and pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to add some whole grain mustard.
Whole grain mustard.
And
for
one
texture
of my,
and flavor.
For texture and flavor.
Texture.
And
just
one
about
of my favorite things to incorporate,
yeah,
apple cider vinegar, too.
Apple cider. Throw
now
it in
the
there.
Why the apple cider vinegar?
You know, it's for flavor, but also it breaks down the fibers in the onions. So it's good to soften the veggies.
Okay, very good.
Wow.
The sweet and the savory of the apples and the onions versus the pork chop is so nice because it cuts the sort of richness of the pork chop.
Mm-hmm. It balances it nicely,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Really, I feel like you could just have this on its own, though.
This
already smells amazing.
Totally, it's so good. And this is such a retro recipe. Like growing up, everyone ate pork chops and applesauce. And, mm-hmm, you know, like if
yeah,
you watch the Brady Bunch.
Pork chops and applesauce.
Listen, the whole time these guys have been talking about the Brady Bunch,
chops
right?
Pork chops and applesauce.
Peter Brady,
I remember that episode,
with his best Humphrey Bogart impersonation.
Right.
Now, do we have
anyway
to add the pork chops back to this?
No.
You don't. So you leave the pork chops out. You've cooked those. Those are done. We sauteed this. How long do you to kind of let the mustard and the apple cider vinegar incorporate?
Just a minute, normally.
Just a minute. Okay,
just
good.
A minute.
And then we're done?
Your plate.
And then we
that's
plate.
It.
How about
yes
that, everybody?
So you want
okay
your apples to still be crispy a little bit. Right?
No, because after 12 minutes, they really soften.
Oh, it's 12 minutes.
It should be 12.
Oh,
this is the magic of TV.
Okay. Yeah,
we've sped it up.
12 minutes.
Yeah.
For the purposes of television.
Okay, very good. But like you say, we're keeping it simple.
Well, while Cameron is plating,
yeah,
you talk about having,
thank you,
sort of key ingredients in your pantry, spices and such, and also not just spices, like different things, swap outs that you could use that you say are very important to help cut back on calories and fat. Will you share some of those with us?
Exactly. I am all about the swaps. And in this book, because we wanted everything to be super simple, some of the things I use a lot of, this is, you know what this is? It's a wonton wrapper.
I was wondering what those were.
So these are
amazing.
I thought
amazing it was a piece of cheese.
I thought little paper towels.
See, all good guesses.
Yes.
They're all wrong. All right, so wonton wrappers, they're only
good
about
wrong
20 calories each.
What?
And you can do so many things with them. You just bake them. I have a like a little muffin pan here. And if you just bake these for a few minutes, they get nice and crispy. And you can use these as vehicles to house anything from desserts to savory hors d'oeuvres, little salads, anything and everything. But again, this is magical because it
feels
only about 20. So you can do a lot with them, and I love them. You find them at the supermarket where you find the tofu. So they're in the fridge section with some of the ethnic foods. And then another one of my favorite MVP ingredients, powdered peanut butter. You guys, do you know what that is?
It's just I've had that before.
I've never heard of powdered peanut butter.
I've never heard of that. It's a revelation.
This is life-changing, honestly.
Is this a new thing?
Yeah, it's not really that new, but luckily it's become very popular, so you can find it at any supermarket. But it's basically peanut flour, so it's peanuts turned into flour without any of the fat or very little fat.
It's so fun. You can put it in your mouth and, like, with your own saliva, make peanut
you
butter.
You can make that. That sounds gross, but it's true.
It's so good, though.
So what do you do with it besides that?
Yeah, besides that.
The thing is, it's really good for baking. It's good for smoothies. It's good for, you could make a peanut butter sandwich out of it if you add water, but it's really good for cooking, and it has a fraction of the calories and fat regular peanut butter
probably
has.
Probably all the protein.
With all the flavor.
Because it doesn't have the oil.
Exactly. So it only has about 50 calories a serving as opposed to 200 calories a serving.
The flavors of this are amazing.
Yummy, right?
Peter Brady knew what he was talking about.
This is chives on top.
So good. I've started. We're sharing.
Okay, good.
It is so
good. Thank you so much. This is delicious. And like you promised, nice and simple, but lots of flavor.
Nice and simple, just the way we like it. Thank you, Lisa, and thank you, Cameron. You did a great job. Big fan of your work. You'll find this recipe on HallmarkChannel.com.